Hello, I'm Jay Alan Zimmerman, song name, Jay. I'm a composer and musician who became deaf, which inspired me to try to create new ways to see sound. Now I'm building on this experience to create a new way to see hearing. There are nearly 8 billion people in this world with 16 billion ears, and virtually nobody understands their hearing. But we all understand your vision, right? If you can see near best, you're called nearsighted. If you can see far best, you're farsighted. If you can see 20 feet away, what the average person sees 20 feet away, you have 20/20 vision. We understand seeing better because we use clear factual terms to describe the ability you have. But for hearing, we're still using sad, ambiguous terms to describe the ability you don't have. Hearing loss. Hearing impaired, hard of hearing. And the weird thing is, most of this negative language comes entirely from a graph, a visualization of hearing data called an audiogram. Its basic framework is older than indoor plumbing, and so its design is based on the philosophy that the best way to measure hearing is by comparing it to an average. So at the top of the graph, it defines some people as normal. And then everyone else becomes mildly, moderately, severely, or profoundly abnormal. They don't say the abnormal part out loud, but that's what this comparison means. This abnormality hierarchy is not only insulting, but also confusing, because it forces all your hearing data to get completely jumbled up in a way that conflicts with your basic understanding of sound. It makes your left ear an X and your right ear an O, because the right side is for high pitch and the left side is for low pitch, because the low part is for loud and the high part is for quiet. But the true natural curve of quiet has been straightened into a line for normal in order to better show how much loss you have from normal and define you as a loser. The resulting image then is not a picture of hearing. It is a picture of a loss. And because hearing has been graphed this way for over a century, some of these pictures of loss have been given names. And that's why a doctor might say to you that you have a ski slope loss, or a cookie bite loss, or you can't hear in the speech banana. Would we tell people with glasses they can't see in a lip apple? Now it's time for a more modern system, which I'm calling the hearing visualizer. A method that is more inclusive and promotes successful outcomes by being focused not on loss, but on ability. One that combines computer accuracy with simple scientific truths. Because in truth, there is no normal, but there is a shared reality. And one thing all humans share is how our bodies react to intense sound waves. Intense sound waves can cause discomfort, pain, ear rupture, and ultimately death, even if you hear no sound at all. Truth one. Too loud is the same for everybody. So if we look at how the full spectrum of sound waves affect humans, too loud is generally a straight line that is common for all, and too quiet is generally a curved line that is different for all. So if you turn the curve of quiet into a straight line, you just turn the straight line of too loud into a curve. So the straight line of loud is restored and visually intersecting with your ears. To warn everybody, this is dangerously loud no matter what you hear. Truth two, things that are closer sound louder. Before the audiogram, doctors tested and measured hearing volumes in terms of distance, writing down how far you can hear, 6 feet, 12 feet, 30 feet, 40 feet. So loud is shown right where you are, and too quiet is shown far away from you. And the distance between too loud and too quiet shows if you are far hearing or near hearing. Truth three, all hearing is important. The other thing all humans share is music. It is a unique human experience embedded into all the rituals of life. But because the audiogram came into existence with the invention of the telephone, it still limits its view to only those tones that are needed to transmit speech over copper wire. The range of tones shown is so limited that the very highest and lowest sounds are left out, including the entire lower half of a piano. The entire full spectrum of human hearing is shown and displayed in alignment with how we think about sound, with the low sounds shown low and the high sounds high and the tones most commonly heard in speech in the mouth area. No more speech banana. And the full spectrum is divided into three easy to understand sections, the bass, the treble, and the high end, where we find all those sounds that are too high for our vocal cords to produce. Truth four, we hear in stereo. We don't have to stay trapped in this side view. The confusion of layered data can be eliminated by separating and mirroring the data for your other ear. This creates a widescreen view of your entire field of hearing. Seeing all your hearing data as a hearing field shape helps you understand your abilities quickly. The average person, previously graphed as a straight line normal, now sees a far hearing field that's wide and open. A person with a ski slope loss now sees a shape like a cave, which shows an ability focused on the bass. A reverse ski slope loss now shows a shape like a valley, which shows an ability focused on the high end. A deaf person like me, previously graphed as severely or profoundly abnormal, now sees a very near hearing field this narrow. But remember, hearing doesn't happen with just your ears. So we can also begin to graft your sensitivity to sound waves through touch and feeling. In fact, once your data is imported, we can do anything. We can layer multiple hearing fields to show how your hearing has changed over time. Layer the potential benefits of hearing technology. Use scientific formulas for sound decay to show, for example, how far away your phone can be if you want to hear it ring. This is just the beginning. No more negativity, no more confusion, no more defining people in levels of abnormality. Because in the hearing visualizer, your left ear is left and your right ear is right. High sounds are high, low sounds are low. Too loud is too close, too quiet is far. Volumes represent actual sound wave intensities, and the full spectrum of human hearing is shown, including every note on a piano. I want all 8 billion of us to understand our 16 billion ears, to make the best use of our hearing field when choosing cell phones and headphones long before needing any assistive hearing technology implants. Because the truth is, eventually everyone needs some hearing assistance. That's normal.